Hello guys, today I have this 2x2 glass hipster door for you. So as you can see, it's fairly fast. I mean, it could be better but it could be worse as well. The thing is though that the closing takes as long as the opening, although it needs to do way less actions, so that means that this happens and then wait a bit and it closes. So yeah, that's the only real downfall to this design, I would think. But I mean, whoops, still, if it's like, it does put the glass all the way up first, so I mean, it's not like you can walk through, so like the quick close the door argument for creeper is a bit invalid. I mean, it's still not super fast, but it's not as if yeah, the mob could pass. So yeah, let's take a look at the redstone. So here's the redstone, and if you can see, it's pretty damn small. I made this together with Eoptropics, like we both did about half, and Sunlands made it a little bit cheaper, but it wasn't much. And Theo brainstormed with us on some earlier versions, so there's no direct redstone from him in here, but there might be some concepts from him in here. So yeah, it's only 7 high by 11 by 4, which makes it 308 blocks counting the floor. So my old one was something like 315.50 without counting the floor. So yeah, that's quite a nice improvement, and that one was really small already. So yeah, the only real drawback is the speed. But yeah, the opening is fine, so that's probably the thing you would like the fastest. And yeah, the closing is just a bit slow. So yeah, let's go to the tutorial. Okay, so now for the tutorial. You again would need to find where you want to build it. Then you need to follow yeah, this layout pretty much, which I saw at first at Swaggerize or Super Swaggerize, his video, I believe. I will link it, but apparently some other people have done it earlier as well. Or, well, not earlier, but have done it as well. I don't know who came up with it first, pretty much. So this is your business layout, and one drawback of this as well is that it will swap these two blocks every time. So yeah, you would pretty much want to have these two blocks the same, otherwise it's gonna yeah, change every time, as I said. So this would be it in his open state, and then we want to start off with the making it all seamless at the end, like bring up these blocks. We want a furnace there, which we will use later. Oops, screwed up there. So this is pretty much your input, and this is what will close it every time. So we will have a timer hooked up to it, because a button press isn't long enough for it. So this needs to be a slab, And I'm misplacing blocks all over the place, but yeah. Oops, and a better there and one here. So this isn't really cheap, but it works fine. So if we now power this, this will be your input block. Nothing happens because somehow I place this there instead of there. So now if you power it, it would start opening and it will in the end close it. So that's why the delay is so huge when it's closing as well, because we use the same pulse extender, or yeah, pretty much. So then we start at the main part for closing. Would be something like this. Okay, it should actually be all one forward. So like this. Two tick there, and four ticks on these. Then we will need a dual edge right here. So place it over there. These will need to be all slabs. And we need to cut off a signal over there. And then we need to power the pistons with it. So I believe this should be about your closing. So let's test that. Okay, that didn't work because this should be in vortex. I don't know when I changed that, but I think I just misclicked. So as you can see, this is yeah, your closing done. It will look a bit different later because there's some unused pulse for the yeah, this part, but it's pretty much that. Then we'll have another input over here. And we will have an input for like the main triple and double circuit over there. So there, this is pretty much the input line, and then we have one tick repeater there and there, and some torches going up. Some additional wiring for the triple already. Oops, I was stuck right there. Then a four tick there and a one tick there, so that makes so this doesn't turn off all the time. So it doesn't create a clock pretty much. If you screw that up, it would create a clock. And then that. So actually we need some lock right here as well. Yeah. Oops. Normal piston here, so that basically creates ledge, sort of, so one of the circuits will only trigger once instead every time. When it shouldn't, basically. It's a bit hard to explain, but this should be a big part of your opening done. So if we power this, you can see the first pulse, and then yeah, this would still be up, sort of. I just need to reset it to demonstrate it, but normally that wouldn't matter. So then you give it a, or we just need to give it a 3 tick pulse, and after that a 4 tick pulse, and that's basically your whole thing done. And then it would be able to close again. So now there's a bit too much delay, so we just need to have a way to power that. So this is a really smart thing Yoptropics did. So we basically have a binary counter over here, sort of, because there's a dual edge, and then that dual edge goes into the flip-flop, so that makes it just give one pulse again, like the input of the dual edge does. And it's also on the second pulse that it fires, so it gives it a bit more delay. And then this will be your the flip-flop, so it doesn't fire when it shouldn't. And then the flip-flop simply powers 3 tick here, powers this one, so that's the first 3 tick I demonstrated. And then the 4 tick comes from down here, because that basically fires it at the same spot, which is these blocks basically, but just from another way, from another place I mean. So this should be it working, I hope, if I didn't screw up. Okay, seems like I did screw up. So I will need to check what I did wrong. Okay, so I found out why it didn't work. There's one really obvious reason, and that's that I didn't, well, for me it's obvious anyways, didn't place those repeaters there, because now it would try fire dual edge when it's trying to do the triple as well, and we don't want that. So this basically locks the dual edge, because the piston still moves, but the redstone wire is powered all the time. And one kind of weird thing, this repeater updates, I think, the one of the pusher pistons, and that makes it screw up, or it updates one of these pistons, I'm not sure. But yeah, you need to place it all the way around, so then it works. So now we can give it another try. As you can see, it's really slow, but works fine. So there it is. Now, if you would like to make it a bit faster, you can add some additional circuits. Well, one additional circuit, actually. So you need to change that with a slab. You need to have a 4 tick in here. In the block, one repeater, a piston. If it's opened like this, it should be in this state. If it would be closed, you should have it like that. Put this on subtract, just to be sure. I'm not sure if needed, but I prefer them in subtract anyways. And this should fasten up your closing. That seems to have been one tick too fast. Yeah, give me 1 second. So I just tested it a bit with Theo and Yoptropics, and we found out this only works because of an external circuit we had, which I will show you after this one. But by simply doing this, it should work all the time. So it should work with this normal button here as well. And as you can see, it's quite a bit faster when closing, and the opening is not affected by it. So yeah, that's really nice. And now if you want to have the input like I had at the beginning, you would want to place a block right there. You can have your buttons on both sides of it. Then you place the blocks like following. Yeah, I'm just going to do this with other color because I think I'm trapped. Because it's still within the size of the thing. Sure, yeah. And then we place torch there and some torches over here. Then we want to take an output from this. Yeah, it's a bit complicated, but I couldn't really find a better way to do it. So then you remove that, place torch here, torch in there, torch there, repeater there, torch there, and a vortex over here, and then you can place that back and it should be good to go. So there's the closing, and the opening. So as you can see, it's still fairly small, and I think these two circuits are, yeah, make the door a lot better. I like the input like this, but maybe you want to do some redstone yourself and make it close behind you, I don't know. So you don't have to use it, and it's not required for the door either. So yeah, that's all for this video. Check people out in the description again, although you probably know them because I do a lot of redstone with them. Apart from Super Swagger Eyes, you should check him out. He has really awesome redstone creations. And yeah, that's all. See you all later. Bye.